Here are the topics of our February 2023 robot news. We bring you the robot highlights of CES 2023. Two German robotics companies have raised millions in investments, and ABB continues to expand with new cobots and a new fully automated factory in China. Enjoy! Hello, my name is Werner Hampel, and if you like our monthly news, give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to activate the bell to get notified when we upload new videos. Now let's get started in our news. As always, the new year began with the CES in Las Vegas. Every year at the Consumer Electronics Show, the latest innovations from the world of technology are presented. While the focus is mainly on televisions, computers, gaming, and home electronics, there are always new robotics innovations as well. This year, there were fewer robot highlights than in the last few years, but there were still some interesting ones. The first comes from Autonomy. Autonomy introduces the Autobot Yeti, which is a delivery robot for the last mile. The Autobot Yeti is an autonomous mobile robot that can deliver food. The robot is intended for delivery services for groceries and restaurant meals, and also for restaurants in shopping malls. The robot can be used both indoor and outdoor, making it one of the first AMRs that can do that. The robot has two different loading doors, so the customer can only take their own order. Yeti can also grab and unload deliveries on its own. I think delivery robots could have a great future, especially in big cities. So thumbs up for the Autobot Yeti. Aielus Robotics presented the Aeo, a service robot that can be used, for example, for deliveries, as security or even in healthcare or hotels and restaurants. Aeo has two arms, one which is equipped with a gripper, so the robot can pick up objects, open doors and push buttons. The other one has a new video wire which allows the robot to sanitize surfaces. It has a 360-degree camera with night visions and can be used for surveillance. In addition, it can also detect when patients need help. It can lift around 4 kilos, 9 pounds, and it can deliver food, drink, or other items. Aeo is already being used in airports, hotels, hospitals in Taiwan, Hong Kong, and Japan. And who knows, maybe the Aeo will soon expand all over the world. And lastly, we talk about Meropi's Centif, an agricultural robot that looks pretty funny. It can move across fields autonomously and scan crops to check their health status. Thanks to its unique wheel design, it doesn't harm the plants as it moves across the field. According to Meropi, the robot can learn more about plants' condition than a human can. It can determine a plant's water and nutrient needs, identify biological hazards, monitor growth and phenotype. That means that the robot can look inside the plants, so to speak, to find out about its characteristics. I find agricultural robots very interesting, and even if the Centif looks a bit strange at first glance, it is really a high-tech robot that will certainly serve farmers well. So much from CES. There wasn't a really big highlight, but I think these three robots could have great potential. So what do you think? Feel free to write me your opinion down in the comments here below. In Germany, we have a big growing startup business for robotics. I think it's very interesting for the world too, yeah? Because here in the Robotics channel, we are proud, of course, of our German robotics companies that are shaking up the scene. We have featured Fruitcore on the channel before, so we are delighted that the Konstanz-based robotics manufacturer has been able to raise a further 23 million euros, or $25 million in investments. In total, the company is now valued at 84 million euros or $90 million. Food Car was able to double its own valuation within a year. In 2021, the company's value was still 45 million euros or $85 million. The financing round at that time also paid off liabilities, but the new investments can now be put almost entirely into company's growth. German investors dominate and the company's founders continue to hold a significant stake. Jens Rigger, CEO and co-founder of Foodcore, explains that one of the big goals for 2023 is to expand to the European market. Yes, and of course, next into the world market. The investments show the concept of the horse robot is attracting a lot of interest. At the beginning, there were still critical voices, myself included. I was not quite sure whether horse is really suitable for industrial use and so on. But in the meantime, Foodcore has really convinced me and many others. Congratulations to Foodcore, and we wish the company continued success. But not only Foodcore can be happy about investments. The Munich-based company Robco was also able to collect 14 million euros. Robco is one of the first providers of modular lightweight robots. And thanks to the new money, this results in valuation of around 50 million euros of the company. The founders still hold more than 50% of the shares, and together with German investor Frank Thelen, they even have 2/3 majority. It is currently not known what the money will be used for, but it's possible that it will be invested in the global expansion. In any case, we are excited. We were already able to get an idea of the modular robots at Automatica 22 and loved the concept. And now the news from ABB. The robot manufacturer has 3 new Cobot models to offer and has opened a fully automated factory in Shanghai. Just before Christmas, ABB surprised everyone by announcing that the ABB Swifty CRB1100 Cobot is getting big siblings. The CRB1100 can lift around 4 kilograms and has a reach around 58 centimeters, while the new models can lift 7, 10, 11 kilograms and have a reach from 0.9 meters to 1.4 meters. Yeah. The Cobots are designed for use in industrial environments, are 6 times faster and 5 times more precise than other robots in their class, and have a repeatability of 0.01 millimeters. The Swifty CRB1300 is designed to bridge the gap between the industrial and collaborative robots. It can be used in various manufacturing and handling applications such as machine tending, palletizing, pick and place and so on. All in all, it sounds very promising. Maybe we can test an ABB Cobot soon. We would really like that. ABB, contact me. But that's not all. ABB has also opened a awesome, fully automated and flexible robot factory near Shanghai. Around $150 million have been invested in this 67,000 square meter production and research site. ABB's own digital and automation technology will be used to produce the next generation of robots. ABB is committed to an in China for China strategy, meaning that 90% of all robot solutions ABB sells in China will be manufactured in this factory. China is, of course, a huge growth market, and ABB is looking to expand its position there. The new site is a prime example for Industry 4.0, combining the physical and digital worlds and creating a digital ecosystem for production. Virtual planning and production management systems improve performance by analyzing data. Instead of fixed assembly lines, flexible modular manufacturing cells are digitally connected and operated by intelligent, autonomous and mobile robots. AI-powered robots screw, assemble and handle materials, freeing up employees to take on more attractive tasks. There is also an 8,000 square meter research and development center where the company's new innovations are being developed. In addition to the plant in China, a new global innovation and training campus for machine automation has already opened in Austria in July 2022, followed by a learning factory 4.0 in Berlin in September. ABB is making Industry 4.0 and Smart Factory a reality. What do you think about it? Feel free to write me your opinion below in the comments. That was our news in February 2023. If you liked the video, give a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to activate the bell to get notified when we upload new videos. And I see you in the next video. Werner.